What's going on, everybody? This is Joe.
And Amy.
And we are back with another episode of Life is Strange Before the Storm. If you're confused by what we're looking at here, then you must have missed the last episode, and you should definitely go check it out so that this becomes a little bit clearer to you. But last time, I guess spoilers, we finished episode one, and obviously I don't mean episode of this series, I mean episode of this game. And Chloe started, no, sorry, not Chloe, Rachel started a forest fire.
Yeah.
A quite large one.
Accidentally, but still.
Well, she kind of definitely didn't care though, but she did it by burning a picture of her and her dad.
Yeah, great.
and then obviously because of the way that this game works, or these games work, also, because it was the end of an episode, we got to go through all of our prior decisions up to that point, see what our percentage was compared to everybody else, and kind of have a bit of a discussion on it. So, truly, if you missed that last episode, I do recommend that you go check it out. But, are you ready, Amy?
Yeah.
Let's see what we've got going on today. We'll go to episodes, and now we are here for episode 2, Brave New World, because we just finished episode 1, Awake.
Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm. I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
Hey, dickhead!
Get the fuck out of here!
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
We don't have to like each other. But you will respect me.
Hello, Blackwell.
Chloe, do something!
Hey, do you know if Rachel is a gamer?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here. Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Damn, they are really going at it.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman? That was my dad.
Oh, that's right, and the wind powers.
Was definitely not my mom.
Oh, Black Hell.
That's right. Principal, whatever his name is.
We're back at school.
Mm-hmm.
Miss Price, how good of you to join us.
I'm so sorry we're late. My shift ran late at the diner, and then just sorry.
Let us proceed. One of you here is new to the Blackwell disciplinary process, and the other is all too familiar with it. Blackwell's code of conduct is built upon a foundation of mutual respect meant to foster an environment conducive to education and
enrichment. Blah, blah, blah.
Jesus.
Okay. Reality check time. Yesterday did actually happen. I ditched school with Rachel Amber, and then Rachel really did start that fire. And that was after we actually agreed to run away from here. Right?
Are you paying attention to me, Chloe?
What?
Miss Price, the last time we met, an agreement was brokered. Do you recall what that was?
Say nothing, don't screw up, or is that rhetorical?
Say nothing.
No. Let me refresh your memory. We agreed that you would rededicate yourself to becoming an exemplary Blackwell citizen.
Uh-huh.
What a weird way to put that.
In the event that you were unable or unwilling to do so, we also agreed that it would become pertinent to reassess your future status at the Academy. Despite all this, You engaged in the following actions yesterday. Insubordinate language. Disregarding posted signs about trespassing on the stage. Confirmation of drug use.
What?
Allegedly. I didn't see any witnesses.
This is not a trial, Miss Price. This is a sentencing. Shall I continue? Witnesses saying you were involved in bullying Nathan Prescott.
The hell I was. I stood up for that little weirdo.
I suppose that's one interpretation of events.
No, that's what happened.
Say what you will about my daughter, but she is not a bully.
Maybe you should be talking to Drew instead of me. You know, the guy who actually did what you're accusing me of.
Mr. North's situation requires sensitivity. It will be handled separately.
Wow.
Oh, I get it.
The situation is less sensitive.
Yeah. Wow.
I do not discuss other students.
Because
situations.
He's an athlete, right?
Here to discuss your daughter and her actions.
Good point.
Convenient.
Yeah. Reassure your mom or calm the principal.
Reassure mom.
Mom, you know this is all bullshit, right?
I'm beginning to suspect that myself.
I am sorry you feel that way, but your daughter's misbehavior is real and serious. And yet, even with your prodigious disciplinary record, Miss Price, we needn't discuss any of it.
We needn't?
No, because you severed your relationship with Blackwell the minute you left school grounds without permission.
Why?
What does that mean?
It means you forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
This isn't a boarding school.
What?
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 What? Yesterday was all me. My idea. I was having a bad day. I needed to blow off some steam, and I took it too far. Chloe tried to talk me out of it. I've been down that road, she told me. You're better than this, but I wouldn't listen.
See, those acting classes have helped, I swear.
Right?
I'd get in trouble or hurt, so she came with me, but only to keep me safe. I'm so sorry you got caught in it, Chloe, that you allowed me to drag you down to my level. Can you forgive me?
Of course, or for what?
Of course.
Yeah. Sure. We're cool. Thank you. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
Chloe, is this true?
It's true. Totally not true. She really is an amazing actress.
Miss Price?
Bullshit or yeah, fine.
Yeah, fine.
Fine, yes. It was her idea, but it's not like she kidnapped me. We were in it together.
Miss Amber, based on what you've just told me, I have grounds to punish you. Are you sure what you've told me is the truth?
Yes.
This can't be the full story, Rachel. Ray.
Just to be clear, Miss Amber, you're sure Chloe Price didn't coerce you or...
Coerce her?
I'm just trying to get to the bottom of why someone like Rachel...
Oh, I think we're clear, Principal Wells. Someone like Rachel, but not my daughter.
Excuse me?
Do you have a list of students you assume the worst about?
Goad her on or just enjoy the show?
Goad her on. She deserves as much support as she can get right now.
Make the situation worse. Got it. All right.
Yup.
Go, Mom.
You have no right to treat Chloe this way. This is because she's on financial aid, isn't it?
Wow. Oh, shit.
Wow. She calls us high risks.
High risks? What kind of a label is that to put on a child? Oh, I get it. This is about Blackwell's money troubles. Will you be dragging every other scholarship student into your office today as well?
Damn.
Let's all just calm down.
After everything she's been through in the last 2 years, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Damn right.
Miss Price.
That is
Mrs.
correct.
Mrs. Price.
Yeah.
Mrs. Price, I appreciate your position, but I assure you, it is only your daughter's past behavior that has led us here today.
That's I not understand, true. Mr. Wells. There is no doubt that Chloe's behavior must improve. But given what we've just learned about the negative influence she was under, I hope you will allow her just one more chance.
Miss Amber,
why is there, like, snow in here?
As I am disappointed in you.
I think it's ash outside.
I understand.
Mm-hmm.
This being your first infraction in no way reduces its severity. Still, we will not be suspending you at this time.
Good.
But you have squandered our trust. You will no longer be my administrative assistant first period.
Oh, and is that what she was doing?
And you will no longer be involved in Blackwell's performance of The Tempest.
Oh, hell no.
Oh, no. What? Are you insane? Or the performance is tonight?
What? Shit. The performance is tonight.
You want to say that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
But the performance is tonight.
For someone so aware of our school calendar, Miss Price, I would expect fewer absences on your record.
Wow.
Ray, she loves that show. Since this is her first infraction, don't
Mr.
you
Amber,
think,
I don't tell you how to run the district attorney's office. Please don't tell me how to run my school.
But you suck at it. You're a
There's
fucking
a
dickhead.
We have understudies for all circumstances, accidental and deliberate. I'm sure your understudy.
Victoria Chase.
Oof.
Yes, I'm sure Victoria Chase will do fine.
Oof.
That is such...
What was that, Miss Price?
Chloe is upset for her friend, but we are both grateful that she is not going to be unduly blamed for what happened.
There is plenty of blame to go around. Chloe's future at Blackwell will be discussed next, unless you had something to add first, Miss Price.
Take the blame.
Really?
Yeah. Do
but,
it.
But your mom, she stood up for you and everything.
I know. She did the right thing, and so did I, by doing what Rachel wanted and needed done. But if this is the consequence, take the blame.
All right, so this
she
is,
deserves to be in that show.
So this is going to be one of those things where we got to answer quickly.
Okay.
The Gab things.
Okay.
Which means we have a chance to win this, so let's see what we can do.
All right.
Ready?
Yeah.
No way is Rachel missing the play for me. But thanks to her acting skills, I'll have to go down in flames if I want to fix this.
To succeed in backtalk, listen to your opponent and choose a related comeback. So again, if you recall, these will be timed. If we don't answer, we don't answer.
Okay, now so, you're making me anxious.
Yes,
just do it.
We should be anxious. I will read it. I will read it quickly, as quickly as I can.
Okay.
You tell me which one you want.
Okay.
Three, two, one.
Get your head out of your ass, Wells. Chloe, you seriously think yesterday was Little Miss Sunshine's idea?
Miss Amber has accepted her responsibility.
If it quacks, accept reality or you are unacceptable.
Accept reality.
Don't you have the slightest idea how this works? You don't wake up one morning and decide to be an outlaw. You need priors. You need training.
Rachel confessed. Are you calling her a liar?
You should confess. I confess she can act, or she just wants attention.
I confess she can act.
To thinking she can act like a motherfucker. You just bought her crap. Hook, line, and sinker.
You don't have to do this. It's okay. Really.
We're not friends. You do you, or you don't tell me what to do.
You don't tell me what to do.
Don't tell me what to do. I'm not one of your sycophants. I'm a lone wolf, and you're a little Red Riding Hood. Welcome to grandmother's house, bitch.
Chloe, this can't be you. Apologize this instant.
I regret bullying Nathan. Sorry for making you look bad, or shouldn't have dragged Rachel into it.
Shouldn't have dragged Rachel into it.
Fine.
Ooh.
I shouldn't have pulled Rachel out of class.
That didn't work.
If I'd known she couldn't handle it, I would have gone it alone.
Why speak up, Miss Price? Your words do not exonerate Rachel, but they do further implicate you.
Why not tell the truth? Why not leave with a bang, or I'm the worst?
I'm the worst.
Like you always say,
you're lost.
I'm the worst student Blackwell's ever had. Doesn't it feel good to be right?
That's enough. Your loyalty to each other might be admirable, but nothing else about your attitude or behavior is. My decision stands. Miss Price will be suspended for the rest of the school year. Miss Amber will be cut from the play.
Wow.
I will have Skip Matthews escort you to clean out your locker. You may wait outside my office until he arrives.
Can I take a dump there?
That is all.
I'm going to do it whether you say it's okay or not.
Price, Mr. and Mrs. Amber.
Ray.
Come on, Chloe.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Meet me at the junkyard later?
You bet.
I didn't get the chance to introduce myself. I'm Joyce.
Mrs. Price.
I'm Rose. This is James. I'm sorry we had to meet like this.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sure for you this is an unusual circumstance.
We really should be going. Nice to meet you.
Mom,
I'll see you in the parking lot.
Hey, Chloe. I'm supposed to walk you out.
Just you and me. Hey, Skip.
Fuck 'em. Bunch of fascists.
Yeah. Thanks,
hey,
Skip.
Just wanted to say it sucks what is happening to you.
Thanks, Skip.
You're gonna be missed.
I don't really care about any of this shit. Except my secret stash. Might as well grab my emergency joint while I'm here.
Okay, well, we've got a photo. We've got a pencil case. We've got a sign, a chemistry book, the locker, or a doodle.
Let's just look at everything.
Oh, and there's, what is that considered? Homework. Oh. All right, well, let's look first at the picture, the photo.
Dad got Bongo from the rescue shelter. Then he got run over by a car. Moral of the story, no one's ever really rescued.
Yep, that's true.
So do we leave it there or take it?
We take it.
The homework.
Love how every time someone tells me how much potential I have, it's right before saying how I'm wasting it all.
So it is chemistry homework, or Chloe Price chem lab, I guess January 17th write-up. F. Chloe, I need to start seeing more effort from you, or you're going to fail my class. The quality of your work lately simply doesn't speak to the amount of potential I see in you. I know you're better than this.
Wow. I mean, it looks like she did the work here, and she just got it wrong. Like,
yeah.
She just doesn't know it.
Yeah.
But, you know, if she's skipping so much class, that's why.
Sure, yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do we trash it or leave it?
Leave it. Who gives a shit?
Okay. Pencil case.
Yeah, let's look at that.
Trusty keeper of my graffiti pets. You've served me well.
Huh. Okay. Look.
Wonder who will grace this space after me.
Do we sign it?
Yeah.
Almost. Look at this cool pirate.
Yeah.
I had big plans for adding to this collage. Oh well. Maybe Kim was the class I hated the least.
Do we take it or leave it?
Take it. Oh. Okay.
Okay. Geometry.
We could study it at home and get better at chemistry. Yeah. No.
No.
Okay.
Having Justin as my locker neighbor was one of the few not shitty things about this place. If Chloe leaves Blackwell at 11 a.m., going 100 miles per hour, how long will it take her to get as far away as fucking possible?
Not long. 100 miles an hour is really fucking fast.
Also, that is not geometry. No, it's not. Just throwing that out there. Leave it or trash it.
All right. I hid my stash behind the poster, which is behind my books.
All right, so let's trash the book so we can get at the stuff.
I should write a poem to mark the occasion. Something with imagery.
Trash it or leave it?
I guess we trash it. I'd rather keep it, but
oh,
that's me.
Sorry.
It's not one of the options.
No.
Absolutely, positively the best concert of 2008. Too bad it's time to go.
We don't get to keep this either?
Wow, you really it made me press a button to read the word metal that is gigantically splayed across the top of this fucking poster. Wow. Okay. Yeah, anyway, apparently we have to throw it out to get to the joint back there.
Okay, fine.
Finally, what I actually came here for.
I don't even see it there.
Yeah, me neither. It looks like just a hole, but yeah. I guess we'll see in a sec.
Jackpot. Wait. What the hell? Damn it, Justin.
Chloe. Heyo. Had to borrow your stash. Desperate times, you know. I promise I'll get you back next week, Justin.
Okay.
Fuck every inch of this place. I wish I could tag it from floor to ceiling. But with Skip watching me... bathroom. Then I'm out. Cool?
Okay. But try to make it fast, will you?
We didn't take the pens. Did we take the pens?
No. Yeah. But we still have some. Insubordinate Wells. Women take forever to get ready, David. There will be consequences. I'm leaving, Rachel.
This is wonderful. She's fearless about standing on high things.
I know.
That are not very sturdy.
Oh, it's a big
so
bird.
Cool.
Yeah. Ha ha ha! Take that, Victoria.
Yeah, right.
Oh, good. David's here.
Great.
That'll make everything better. Oh, it's Justin.
Oh, good. Someone we can say goodbye to who's actually going to care.
Yeah.
Later, Skip.
Later.
Skip cares.
Yeah, but, I mean, she's not going to see him later.
Nope.
That's a lot.
David's here. Awesome.
Let's read this announcement on the ground.
We've got a text from Rachel. I'll read them all in a minute. Once we can... Okay. Come on. Hello?
What? I've been reading it.
No, not you. The game. I want to let me...
Oh, get up.
Another letter. Oops. To Max.
Damn it.
That I'll never send.
Oh, here we go. I got it. Okay.
At least Journal Max won't abandon me the way Real Max did.
Okay. Did we not read these? I thought we did. Okay, so this was the other night while we were out, and she kept texting to say, you know, I need you to do better. Chloe, I'm worried about you. Please let me know you're okay. Chloe, did you hear there's a fire? Please text me so I don't worry. Chloe, are you okay? Chloe, please... She finally, at 11:44, says, I'm fine. Oh, thank goodness. Come home by curfew. You have that meeting early tomorrow. And then, again, Chloe? Really? Chloe, you can't keep doing this to me. I am trying my best.
Yeah, her mom's really cool.
Yeah. She is. All right, we gotta get Rachel's texts, though. All right, so... let's see. Wow. Made it into my house without seeing either of my parents. So this was from last night. Oh. Chloe says, sweet, you were born to be a spy, jumping out of trains and shit. So Rachel says, oh man, we'd make such a great team. No enemy viewfinder would ever be safe from you again.
Exactly.
Chloe says, haha, meanwhile, you're deep undercover as a passed out person. LOL, today was unforgettable. Some of it sucked. Yeah. You know what doesn't suck? What? You. You also don't suck. I know. We should probably sleep. Got Wells tomorrow morning. Yeah, my fault. Worth it. Wells blows. That meeting hella sucked. You're hella weird. You are. Seriously, we'll get revenge.
Yeah, we will.
We've got a new message from Elliot and Principal Wells and the ABFW alert system.
About the fire department, yeah. I was like, what the fuck is that?
Urgent fire weather update. Arcadia Bay Forest Watch. Arcadia Bay. Arcadia Bay, like Oregon. 2:02 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, Saturday, May 8th, 2010. Active D, Class D wildfire, not contained. Use caution. Check local media for road closures. Principal Wells, members of the Blackwell community, please be advised that a fast-moving wildfire has recently been sighted in the vicinity of Culmination State Park. I have spoken with the Arcadia Bay Forest Watch, who do not believe any evacuations are necessary at this time, as the Blackwell campus is not within the affected area or the fire's current projected path. Please utilize caution while traveling to and from campus. Faculty and staff have been asked to waive punctuality requirements for all sports and extracurricular activities this weekend.
Oh, I see. That's why. He's allowed to be bully, and he's allowed to be late because he's an athlete, but, you know, Drew I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But, you know, we can't be late or gone or anything, even though this isn't a fucking boarding school. It's just a school. You fucking prick.
All right, and here's Elliot. He says, holy shit, did you get Wells' text about fire? You okay? She says, yeah, you? Yeah, I'm just in my room. Hey, after Tempest, you want to hang out? No response.
Shit.
Because we were supposed to go with him.
Yeah, but now... what's the point? Oh, Rachel's not in it anymore.
Yeah. All right, so here is the messages to Max. All right, we read this one. I don't think we read this one. Max. I don't even know. I don't. First off, was your money on Chloe blows this and goes back to having no friends again? I hope so. How did I fuck it up? One moment I'm having the day of my life. Next moment I'm awkwardly confessing feelings for her like some dork asking the head cheerleader to the prom.
Yeah.
And she blew me off, because of course she did. But wait, that's not all. Because as soon as Rachel leaves, I find a car. My dead dad's fucking car. This twisted, shattered, ugly reminder of what used to be my life.
Yeah.
So, I smashed it up, obviously. And then I passed out and had a dream where my dad told me to find Rachel back at the park, and Rachel set herself on fire. But enough about me. How was your day? Signed, Chloe, the twisted, shattered, and ugly.
Love that. Chloe, the twisted, shattered, and ugly. Very cool.
And then the most recent one is from today. Max, when did you decide you were done with me? I mean, how did you know it was time to move on? I ask because Rachel and I have decided we're done with this shit town. We've had it. It's bye-bye bay. But instead of just ghosting it, like someone I know, we're going to leave a trail of destruction in our wake. For Rachel, that means burning a fucking forest down. I know, crazy. But guess what? I'm pretty crazy too. In not unrelated news, I finally got my ass suspended from Blackwell. And Rachel got booted from her play, which strangely sucks even worse.
Yeah, it does.
I should probably be more upset about being a high school dropout, but I'm not. It's just another chapter of fuckery in the story of my life.
Yep.
So yeah, burning bridges, literally and academically. That's how you make an exit, woman. Chloe, the exit wounder.
Nice.
And this flame character flipping the bird is wearing a Jane Doe t-shirt.
Yeah.
And then
it's a flame. I thought it was like a ghost. I was like, I don't know why. Because ghosting.
Oh, maybe.
Max was ghosting.
I thought it was a fire because of the fire.
Yeah. Either way. Right. Could be either one.
Well, now we get to read about James and Rose.
Okay.
You can't trust normal people. Just ask Rachel. Her dad seems like the most normal guy on the planet, but he also turns out to be a cheating dickwad. Come to think of it, maybe that is normal. What sucks is that Rachel is a shithead. Yep. What sucks is that Rachel and her parents actually seemed to get along really well before. James is the new district attorney in Arcadia Bay, which is the reason Rachel's family moved up here from Orange County. Despite his job, James doesn't act like an uptight law enforcer all the time, unlike some wannabe father figures I know. Rose, Rachel's mom, also seems pretty decent. She certainly really loves Rachel and James. Poor lady.
Yeah.
Whatever happens with Rachel's family, it still seems like she really does love her parents. And maybe that's all that matters? I'd certainly rather have a cheating dickwad dad than a dead one.
Yeah, same.
Okay. Well, that's everything. There's an announcement on the ground here.
Max would have loved this shit.
The future needs excellence. Blackwell Academy. Because of a generous grant from the Prescott Foundation, Blackwell will be offering several new courses next fall designed to nurture the artistic gifts of its students. Art 101, Visual Concepts. Art 102, Intro to Composition. Art 103, Intro to Ceramics. Art 201, Intermediate Photoshop. Art 202, Intro to Character Modeling and Animation. Art 301, Photography, and Art 302, Independent Study by Invitation Only. Special thanks to Caroline Prescott.
I have a couple questions about this.
Sure.
One, why do you need a whole course about composition? That doesn't require a whole course. And that's 102? And then ceramics is 103? Ceramics is significantly harder than visual concepts or the concept of composition. That's insane. And then intermediate Photoshop. That's interesting. I guess that's it. Well, I don't have other critiques.
I have one comment. Art 301 is photography.
Yeah.
Which is presumably the class that Max takes in the first game with the professor who turns out to... Blah, 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 blah. So...
So, did she have to take all these other ones that precede it?
I don't know.
In order to get to 301? I mean, 301 is a pretty high, designation for a course.
I think it depends on the college or the school. Because I know when I went to college, like, there were certain upper-level courses that had prerequisites, and then certain ones that didn't, whether they were considered higher level or not.
Okay.
And so for something like this, like, if you are an amateur photographer, maybe you wouldn't want to, not that it's here, but maybe you wouldn't want, like, an intro-level photography course. You'd want a higher-level one, so... I don't know. And I guess for folks outside of the U.S. or for whom this does not make sense, 101, 102, and 103, it doesn't necessarily mean, like, it seems like maybe you were implying that, like, 3 is harder than 2 is harder than 1. It's just a way to, like, number the courses. And, like, 100-level courses are easier, 200-level courses are harder, 300-level courses are harder than that. But, like, if you have, like, 40 different 200-level courses, you could have, like, you know, 235 versus 201, and, like, they'll be completely disparate from one another. That's why it specifies art, because you could also have math or science or whatever, you know.
Yeah, but, okay, so you're saying 101 is easier than the 201 intermediate Photoshop.
Correct.
But not easier than the ceramics class.
Correct. It's just
That's
different.
So wrong.
But what I'm saying is it's just different, like, topics, right?
Yeah.
So obviously visual concepts and, or I should say, photography and intro to character modeling and animation, you don't necessarily have to be into both of those things, you know? They're
right.
just different types of art classes. So.
Yeah, but to think that photography is more difficult than character modeling and animation.
Again, it's not about that medium. It's about that course. So in other words, it's intro to character modeling and animation.
I understand.
As opposed to photography. So in other words, the concepts discussed in photography go a lot more in depth and become a lot more difficult than they do in the intro courses for character modeling and animation, ceramics composition, etc.
I'm sorry, but even an intro course for character modeling and animation or intro course for ceramics is going to be more difficult than just a photography class. I mean, maybe they have, like, intro to photography and, like, an intermediate photography, and this is, like, the hard photography class that's present on this sheet.
Sure.
But, like, still.
Okay.
Just, like, the concept of learning photography is not going to be as hard as the concept of character modeling and animation. Like, it's just not.
Right.
So, I don't know. I call shenanigans on it, but that's just me. That's, you know, that doesn't need to be everybody.
Can we
know?
Talk about the Blackwell logo for a second in the top left? So, the brown box with the white letter B in it.
Yeah.
And the white letters of Blackwell going along the side. The B is taken off of Blackwell because the B is there.
Right.
But the brown letters for Academy, the A is missing. But that W is not the A.
No, it's not.
It's not Blackwell Academy. It's just the... that doesn't make any
sense.
It's
not Academy? Yeah, okay. They didn't try very hard with this, is what I'm feeling like.
Like, what the hell?
They didn't think we would spend this time looking at
it. What a terrible logo. Okay.
All right.
Anyway.
Let's move on.
Okay. It's a moped.
Three guesses whose bike this is, and they all start with Miss Grant. Damn. I guess I will miss one thing about this place.
Seems like she's named multiple things that she'll miss about this place.
Yeah, actually.
Whether she wants to admit that or not.
Right.
Wells's car. Crushing spirits must pay pretty well.
Yep, it sure does.
Yeah.
Taking pride in Blackwell Athletics means taking pride in yourself. Also, the trustees and their enormous bank accounts.
What does that have to do with Bigfoot?
That's their mascot.
Oh.
Oh, the fire safety flyer.
I guess this fire is no joke. Still can't believe Rachel started it.
Due to the forest fire in the area, Arcadia Bay is on high fire safety alert. Know your role. Number one, respond to fire alarms immediately and in an orderly fashion. Number two, review your emergency exit locations in school and at home. And number three, discuss emergency protocol with your parents or guardians. Do your part to help keep Arcadia Bay safe.
I'm happy that we get to leave this place and no longer be told, know your role. Because fuck you.
But we get to talk to Elliot first, and maybe yes. We can like let him know about not going to the Tempest with him tonight, possibly.
Either that, or maybe we do go. We go with Rachel and Elliot, and we sit there and heckle the whole time. Look, or something.
It says Katniss. Huh. Okay, anyway.
Elliot and I have gone to school together since we were in kindergarten until today. Hey, Elliot.
What brings Chloe Price to school on a Saturday morning? Nothing good, I bet.
I was suspended.
Wait, really? Holy shit!
I know. I'm surprised it took this long, too.
Do you want a hug?
Okay, or no, yeah. Thanks. Yes?
Well, it's me, so I'll take a hug.
Sure.
Okay.
Ugh.
Thanks. Yeah, it sucks for Rachel, too. She was kicked out of the play because of me.
She'll live.
Whoa.
Harsh, man.
Yeah.
Anyway, what are you doing here?
I thought I should come early to grab tickets.
Oh.
For the Tempest? You said we might see it together.
Oh, right. Good call.
Did you get my text about hanging out afterwards?
Ditching the show? Yeah, maybe. Or, sorry, no.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not really big on making plans. But maybe.
Cool. Sounds good.
I better go. My mom is waiting to stick her attack mustache on me. Her boyfriend. Don't worry about it. See you around, Elliot.
Yeah. Later.
Oh. Is he holding them?
Oh. No, that's okay. His phone. I don't know if he's gotten
like,
the tickets.
Does he have the tickets in his hand going like, I bought these for us. I'm sorry, wow. That sounded so mean.
It really did.
I didn't mean it to sound that mean. I really didn't, I promise.
Does that bumper sticker say sneaky dong?
Yes.
Crusty rim, ghouls and girls, ear cheese. This has got to be Skip's car.
Lung butter.
Feline fister.
Pisshead. These are the bands he likes.
Yeah, exactly. I think Pisshead is his, right?
Yeah.
Pisshead much? That has to be Skip's car.
That's what I said. Deadbeat babies. Feline fister is an interesting one.
Yeah, I love that one.
Lung butter as well, yeah. I like that too. Hey, a skateboard.
At least I'll have plenty of free time to take up skateboarding again. If I feel like it.
All right, here we go. You ready?
Look how he parked.
I know.
Damn time.
David, please.
Mom is clearly fighting to hide her disappointment, which, of course, just makes this worse.
Chloe, your mother and I have been talking.
Uh-huh.
I don't care, or can we please do this later?
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
Or what? Or she's my mother.
She's my mother.
If my mother has something to say, she will say it to me.
She has. The problem is, you don't listen.
No,
maybe
you don't.
If you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? Like how to have no job? Or how to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
You had a scholarship, Chloe. Do you know what that means? What kind of opportunity you gave up? Do you want to work at the diner?
Nothing wrong with that, or someone needed my help.
Someone needed my help.
Someone needed my help.
Who? Your friend Rachel? Because I think the daughter of the DA is going to be just fine. I need your help. Me, your mother. We need to get our own house in order. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I care about Joyce very much. I'm willing to forgive you for the incident yesterday. If you improve your attitude going forward.
Incident? What incident?
Chloe was incredibly out of line. She insulted me, swore at me. But with an apology, I'm willing to start over.
You were wrong, not me.
Sure or no?
But I'll say sure.
Really?
I have to make this up to my mom.
Fair enough.
Sure. Reset button pressed.
I am glad to hear it. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas. Like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol.
Mom.
Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, I don't need more discipline from you. I need my mom.
I know, Chloe. And I'm sorry, but David feels...
Joyce.
Who gives a shit what David feels?
This is the best way to start fresh.
Let's go, Chloe. Quit stalling.
Just leave it in your pocket.
Well, there you go, Amy. Comply or refuse?
Damn it. Because I would comply. I just wouldn't put the weed up.
Oh, you mean take everything but the weed out?
Right, like, just show that I'm taking everything out of my pockets, but leave the weed in my pocket.
Sure.
Because, like, at that point, I don't think he's gonna, like, frisk me, you know? And if he does, then, you know, fuck him. So I would comply, but I'm sure that complying here means I put the weed on the trunk.
Yeah, I imagine so. But we don't know that she... We don't know if she has any on her... Because you know as well as I do, she didn't find her stash.
Yeah, but she had the one.
I thought she said it was her emergency joint that she was going for.
Yeah, but she had it in her hand. You didn't see that?
I thought that was a rolled up piece of paper that was the letter, the little note.
Oh, was it?
I don't know. That's what I thought. That's how I interpreted
Fine,
it.
Fine, comply.
But she might have more on her than that. I don't know, obviously.
I don't think she does. Comply. Whatever. At this point, I don't even care.
Okay. Comply it is.
This is taking too long.
Fine. You want to see my shit so badly?
The cat picture.
You know what sucks even worse than invading someone's privacy? Doing it for no reason.
You're awfully smug for someone who just got kicked out of school.
Chloe, I'm sorry. Can you forgive me?
I forgive you or you, but not him.
You, but not him.
Sure. As long as you promise to never speak to this asshole again.
Chloe.
Joyce, you can't start apologizing now. This will only encourage her.
That's enough out of you, David. We need to start treating each other better. And that means all of us. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
Oh, I was gonna say out of town.
No fucking way!
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
No. Talk to me, Chloe. Wow. Tell me what you're feeling.
I know I fucked up, or you're trying. I get it.
You're trying. I get it.
You're trying. I get it. I swear I do. And I've been making it harder for you. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
Don't get in.
She has to.
Why?
Where else is she gonna go?
Walk away! Walk away. Don't do it, Chloe.
Hey!
There is no home. Not if he's there.
You called it.
Chloe.
Good job. Go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
Shut up.
It's just a phase, Amy, clearly.
Yeah. Phase him out of existence.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down?
At the junkyard.
Waiting for Rachel.
Yeah.
Got the baseball bat again.
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
And Rachel.
Yeah. She slept here once before.
And honestly, Rachel's a pretty good thing to have left.
Oh, yeah.
And she still has Elliot, too. She hasn't destroyed that relationship yet.
Yeah.
She has opportunity there to... Not that I think she will, but she has opportunity there to mend the fissures that exist in that relationship before it completely falls apart.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
she looking for?
Couldn't tell you. Battery acid?
She found it.
I was gonna say.
This thing is a mess. But maybe I can fix it.
She wanna drive if this car?
If this will ever run again, the first thing it needs is a new battery. Wonder if I can find one around here.
Well, you'll find a bunch.
If you remember.
I don't know if any of them will be good, but you'll find them.
If you remember, she drove a truck that looked suspiciously like this one in the first game.
That's awesome. I do not remember.
A mannequin head.
Guess I was pretty pissed at Rachel last night. Amazing that someone I just met could have made me this angry. I wonder if I'll ever ride one of these again.
Oh, a shoebox.
Leave no trash box unopened. That's my motto.
It's a bobblehead.
I guess I should have looked at it first to see what she had to say about it, but... anyway.
Okay.
My bad.
I think I'm all smashed out. For now.
For now. Okay. All right, no battery in there.
Oh, why not?
It didn't light up.
Oh.
Same with this one. Smut mag.
Nice.
Pretty sure this isn't what Rachel meant when she talked about going to LA to be a model. Then again, it's probably not what this person meant either.
Fun with candy.
Fun with candy indeed. A fire poker.
I know one fire that doesn't need any poking.
A putting green.
You're a long way from the country club, guy. Don't want to leave yet.
Fair enough.
It's turning us around.
It did. It did do that. Posters.
Huh.
Now this is a vortex club I wouldn't mind joining.
Communism, atheism, free love. Outcasts unite. Be whoever you are as we eat, drink, and merrily say fuck you to Reagan and his oppressive capitalist regime.
Wow.
Blackwell Academy class of 81, the Motley Ball.
Oh, we're taking that. Take that.
You can't.
It's fuck. Come on.
Hey, look. A Christmas wreath.
Gotta love a place where even Christmas looks depressing.
Oh, there's a rug over here.
This rug has some miles on it.
Oh. We can grab this beer bottle first.
Bottles everywhere, and not one beer to drink.
But.
This looks all acidic, too. Yeah,
this is no good.
Oh, well. We tried.
So many empty bottles, and not a single beer. Thanks, junkyard.
Yes, we established that in the last fucking dialogue.
Oh, the paint skull that we made.
Yeah.
Wow. I should angry graffiti more often.
It looks really cool.
It does look cool.
A camera. Ooh.
Sorry, Max. I think I'm more jealous of you than anything. Hopefully, I'll be escaping this place soon, too.
Yeah.
First you take my mom, then take my home. Fuck you, David.
What is that?
Toolbox.
Oh.
No trespassing, eh?
Fuck you. This is where I live now. I'm a junkyard kid.
It's not trespassing if it's your home, right?
Exactly.
What?
There's got to be a battery under one of these car hoods, right?
Yeah. So why aren't we opening the literal any?
No, not going over there.
Oh, Dad's car.
Oh. Shoot.
Okay.
Maybe there's another one on the other side here.
Yeah, it's like,
don't
is there,
want to leave yet.
I didn't know if there was anywhere I haven't gone yet. I don't know.
Oh, let's look at the sign.
Yeah, yeah.
American Rust. Sounds about right.
There's a lot of rust here.
Well, we haven't been over here.
I hope Chloe has a updated tetanus shot.
Right?
You're a long way from the beach.
No, not in there. A syringe.
Oh.
Here's a side of Arcadia Bay they don't put on the postcard.
Oh, this one's booted.
It looks good.
Exactly.
This thing looks somewhat new. Maybe the battery still works? What are you trying to hide under their hood?
Oh.
Pop it from the inside.
Yeah. Yeah, it's literally showing you the button. Or the latch, excuse me.
In official car speak, this is the thing that makes the other things do their things. Here we go, the pick of the litter.
Yeah, best one in the whole lot, apparently.
Yes.
There is some, a police notice.
Wow. Shitty ride, drug dealer. Really thought crime paid better.
So it says, warning, this vehicle has been seized and impounded in execution of a warrant/order, Arcadia Bay Police Department. This vehicle is distrained and impounded in accordance with the authority provided by Rule 42 of the Oregon Magistrates Court Rules in pursuance of Section 2-1 of the Narcotics Damage Act of 1985. It is an offense to, without lawful excuse, destroy, damage, or tamper with this property. Oops. We sure did do some of those things.
Yep.
I used to love opening up the diner with Mom before school. I guess those days are now officially over.
Yeah. That sucks.
All right. Hey, welcome, Matt.
This Matt has seen some things. Mostly feet.
Correct. Yes, that's right. All right. I think that's everything. Oh, I lied.
Don't tell me what to do.
But make it a great day. Oh, the mannequin had me saw that.
All right. Let's put a new battery in this puppy.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't think that would have actually happened, and if it did, it probably would have killed her. She must have just touched the, like, two little wires together.
Yeah.
To each other.
I was going to say, there's a screwdriver right there.
Oh,
I mean, there's very small likelihood that this is in a junkyard simply because it needed a battery. Right now.
In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit. I know someone who would be very happy here.
You want to put the bobblehead on?
Yes.
You can hang here, but I get to pick the tunes. Okay? Probably a good idea to cover over this with something.
Yeah, definitely.
Like a beach towel?
Torn seat.
While an escape hatch could be nice, I should probably cover over this massive hole.
Yeah. Like with a welcome mat?
Okay.
I bet if I look, I can find something else to fix inside the truck.
Jesus. Oh.
Maybe there's another light bulb I can put in here.
Okay. So we need a bulb, something to cover the floorboards, and something to cover the seat.
Okay. Something to cover the floor hole. Lack of board.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see what else this trash heap has to offer.
In the next episode.
Boo.
This
rejected.
This was an interesting one. Yeah, you're right. You were rejected in what you wanted to do. Because instead, we're stopping. But guess what, everybody? That means that is the end of this particular episode. But we will be back next week with another one. So please make sure that you are subscribed and you have that bell rung so that you will not miss out on any of our upcoming videos, including more of this series in the coming weeks. You will get those notifications every time one of those videos comes out if you do ring that bell. Also, don't forget that we have other channels, links down in the description box below, for our Magic the Gathering channel, Geek for All.
And Gluten Free for All. I almost didn't remember what I was going to say there. It's okay. Moving on.
And like I said, those links are down in the description box below. Don't forget to sub and ring the bells there as well. And last but not least, please don't forget that likes and shares here on YouTube do, in fact, go a very long way.
Yes.
And we really do appreciate any and all support that you are all willing to give. But for now, from us here at the Geek for All family of channels, I have been Joe.
And I'm Amy.
And as we always say, in whichever video of ours you watch next, we will see you all next time. Thanks, everybody.